Okay. Well, in the previous example, you have seen that we can derive the steady state temperature profile in a copper bar. But you could also make it a little bit more complex by taking a sphere, for example. And in this sphere, a certain amount of energy, Q, is produced. Watts per cubic meter. And if we now would ask to set up a balance between R and R plus dR, we follow the similar way. However, the final balance will be that we will see that we have the phi cube, which is by conduction on the place R, minus phi q on the place R plus dR, plus Q multiplied by the volume. Because we have now a production term here. There's energy produced here in this sphere per unit of volume. And it could be by a chemical reaction internally, but assume that we just have produced it. Well, let's look first at the volume. The volume in this case is the volume of a sphere between R plus dR to the third minus R to the third, because this is a volume. Well, we could approach this a little bit by 4 pi R squared dR. You can try it by yourself, it's approximately the same. Why did I write it in this way? Because we saw in the previous thing, how do we approach this tackle a microbalance between R and dR? We are doing the following. We are dividing by the interval dR, taking the limit, and then we get the derivative of this function. And even similar in this case. So what we will do is we get zero is, well, we divide by dR. So what we get is phi q on the place r minus phi q on the place r plus dr plus q multiplied by 4 pi r squared multiplied by dr divided by dr. We take the limit of dr go to zero, and then we get the first derivative of phi q, and in this case plus q multiplied by 4 pi r squared. Well, you can reduce this further by substituting for phi q Fourier's law, which is 4 pi multiplied by squared multiplied by dt dr, and you see we can now say ddr of plus q multiplied by 4 pi r squared, and this is zero. And now you can see you can derive now the temperature distribution again. You could, if you like, divide f all the terms by lambda multiplied by 4 pi if you assume that constant. And then in this way, you see that you get an extra term which you have to take into account, and you get a completely different distribution than before. What happens if Q is zero? Well, if Q is zero, we can go back, then you see if Q is zero, we have only a balance which only describes steady state conduction in the sphere itself. And that's really easy. You could say, okay, in the middle, we have a T is T0, for example, and here at the end, T is TR, and you could put on some boundary conditions. So you see that even with a production term, you can set up your own microbalance, and you can solve this problem. So you can also have apply this with a Q-term for a flat plate. You can do this for a cylinder. And all the geometries we have treated in our course. Okay, thanks.